Good day, students, and welcome to today's lockdown lesson for personnel training in 5. In hierdie lockdown les gaan ons voort met hoofstuk 6, waar ons bezig is om te kyk na die aanbiedingsvaardighede. What are the skills that you need as a presenter in the business? In the previous video, we looked at questioning, om ondervraging te doen van jou leerders tydens die opleidingssessie. In hierdie video gaan ons bietjie kyk na hoe hanteer ons reaksies en vrae wat beantwoord word deur jou deelnemers, and also how do we get them involved. So if you want to follow me in your textbook, I'm using the new one. Okay, I'm using the new textbook and we are on page 99. In die heel eerste gedeelte wanneer ons gaan kyk is hoe hanteer ons reaksies van jou deelnemers en natuurlijk as hulle enige vrae het of enige stellings maak wat moontlik wat jy nie dadelik kan antwoord. You don't always have an answer to for that or you can't always control the responses. Okay, so wat doen ons in daardie omstandighede en dan gaan ons ook kyk na hoe hanteer mens die betrokkenheid van jou deelnemers. That's very important. So getting them involved and handling their responses is what we're going to cover in this video. Okay, so kom ons begin. They say a trainer will find that individuals will react differently during training. It is imperative that the trainer handle all responses appropriately, of het nou positief is of negatief. Dit is bitter baie belangrik. Net as ek altyd sê vir labor relations, sê ek altyd, it's important to maintain the relationship between the employer and the employees. En dieselfde geld vir 'n opleidingssessie. Daar moet 'n goeie vertrouwensverhouding wees en 'n goeie klimaat van vertroue en rapport tussen jou deelnemers en tussen jou opleier. So jy as 'n opleier het 'n geweldige groot verantwoordelikheid om hierdie verhouding te handhaaf en seker te maak dat jou werknemers en jou veral jou deelnemers se selfbeeld nog steeds reg deur die stelsel goed hoog gehou word. Okay, so we need to maintain their self-image and their dignity. So when we handle their responses or questions, we must do so with a lot of respect and a lot of tact. So, one of the responses that you can get is when a trainee asks a question that the trainee is unable to answer immediately. En dit gebeur nogal gereeld, want hulle vir jou vraag vra en jy dink, ek het nie vir jou antwoord nie. And in this instance, it's very, very important that you're honest and to say, listen, I don't have an answer for you now, or I don't know the answer now, maar ek sal gaan uitvind en ek sal na jou toe terugkom. Okay, so dit is nie 'n skande nie, it's not a shame to not always know the answer immediately, dit gebeur. Vir alles hulle nou vir jou een lekker stywe vraag gooi, nee. But what you have to then do in that instance is to, when you get such a question that you can't answer, go and find the answer and then do get back to the participant. Moet nie net sê, moet ek sien toe terugkom en het nooit doen nie, want weer eens, jy breek die vertrouwensverhouding tussen jou en jou deelnemers. The next response is when the trainee disagrees with the trainer or challenges the trainer or heckles the trainer. Okay, so dit gebeur ook. Jy kry hierdie arrogante kandidaat of het iemand wat regtig net met jou verskil om elke hoek en draai. Ek voel soms hierdie persoon is daarmee jou lewe so moeilik as moontlik te maak en hulle toets jou geduld. And these situations also happen. And the very important thing that you need to know is that you need to still treat them with respect. Don't lose your temper, don't lose your cool, stay professional and try to just remind them that you are not perfect, you are also still learning, but that you have prepared for this training session. Jy moet heeltyd kalm bly. Jy kan nie emosioneel betrokke raak nie, jy kan nie uitbarsting hê nie, you cannot start an argument with them because the rest of the participants will then lose their respect for you. So dit is baie belangrik, as jy agterkom dat hierdie persoon is baie persistent, I would then suggest that you call a break time so the rest of the participants can leave the room so you can have a discussion with the participant one-to-one. Baie kere is die verskil, een persoonlijke een, en noodwendig met wat jy weet nie. So hanteer het baie discreet, excuse, and allow them the opportunity to voice their grievances and complaints, but privately. Okay, so ek sal dan in daardie omstandighede eerder sê, okay, kom ons breek, en ons gesels dan daaroor 'n bietjie later. Okay. Another response that you can possibly get from participants is when you ask a question and someone answers the question but they give you a wrong answer. Nou hier moet jy baie versigtig wees. Jy kan nie vir die ou sê, ag man, moet nie stupid wees hier, dis die verkeerde antwoord nie. Because what's going to happen? If you're going to do that, you're not going to encourage them to answer questions in the future Oké? Jy gaan hulle moraal afbreek, jy gaan hulle selfbeeld afbreek en jy gaan geensins verder die deelname van hierdie betrokke individu nie. To make things worse, if the other participants see how you've handled that situation so poorly, they will also not interact with you anymore. Want hulle gaan bang wees dat jy dieselfde met hulle gaan doen. So be very careful like that. Never ever break down someone's when they give you a wrong answer. There are many ways how you can deal with that. You can say, "Oh, dis 'n baie interessante stelling, maar nie heeltemal wat waarna ek gekyk het nie." Of very good try. Let's see if someone else can also help us with answering this question. Of wat jy kan doen is jy kan die vraag rephrase. So jy kan sê, "Dalk het ek die vraag nie lekker oorgedaan nie. Kom ek vra hom gou-gou vir jou weer." Just to make sure that the person fully understands the question, and then eventually if they cannot answer the question correctly, you can either ask the rest of the class to help him, or you can in a very discreet way help the individual to answer the question correctly. The next response is when a trainee monopolizes the session. Met ander woorde, jy het een kandidaat wat die hele opleidingssessie oordonder. Hulle is diegene wat altyd 'n vraag vra of altyd 'n vraag beantwoord of elke keer 'n statement maak. They're very dominant, and this can discourage some of the other participants to respond. So wat ek in daardie geval sal doen is om te sê, "Alright, kom ons gee vir iemand anders die geleentheid om hierdie keer te antwoord," of "Baie dankie vir jou vraag, kom ons antwoord hom kortliks." Is daar enigiemand anders wat 'n vraag ook het voor die persoon dan die geleentheid gee of kry om verder te praat. So still maintain the relationship, still give them a chance to answer, but also make sure to include everyone else in the meeting as well, in the training session as well. So you can say, "Baie dankie vir jou vraag, dis die antwoord." Okay, so enige ander vraag van iemand anders, so keep it short, keep it sweet. Sometimes your trainees can get sidetracked, so hulle is dalk besig met 'n onderwerp en eweskliik trek hulle weg met 'n ander vraag wat nie noodwendig relevant is nie. So try not to entertain those questions. As I listen, let's stay focused, let's stay at the topic that we are looking at. Maar sommige kere, as hulle aandring op 'n antwoord, probeer dit kortliks antwoord and then move on to the rest. Always maintain the relationship with those type of candidates as well. Jy kry ook 'n geval waar jou opleidingsspanne, jou deelnemers, baie gou verveeld raak. Jy kan sommer sien hulle is verveeld, they're bored. So how do you do that? I would stop the session immediately, do an activity, do a bit of an icebreaker, of kom ons breek vir 5 minute, kry gaan 'n droop draai, kry 'n bietjie vars lug. Or you can start asking a very interesting question, or make a very controversial statement just to get them involved. Gebruik ook 'n bietjie humor. Okay, for using humor, you get them involved, and they will enjoy it a bit more as well. The next one is where you get your trainees that say, "Listen, I'm only here because I have to be here, not because I want to be here." So hulle kom sommer in met 'n houding en sê, "Hoorie, maar ek wil nie eintlik hier wees nie." And you can see it not only in what they say, but in the whole body language. So it's very important in this situation to explain to them, "Listen, this is why we're doing this. This is the purpose of this training course, and I know you are busy, but this is going to benefit you. Dit is baie belangrik, jy moet hulle nog steeds daar hê, maar jy moet ook vir hulle sê dat wat is hulle verwagting, and then share with them what your expectation is for the surrounding situation when it comes to the course as well." Dan natuurlik as daar twee opleiers, deelnemers is wat met mekaar begin disagree, they're in a disagreement with each other and they're fighting, very very important to break that fight immediately, want jy kan die hele klas ontwrig. So rather say, "Listen guys, this is not the time to disagree." You can then as a trainer intervene and try and resolve the conflict immediately and then go on to a next topic. Of jy kan vir hulle sê, "Alright, julle, ek hoor julle verskil. Julle albei is geregtig tot julle opinie, maar ek dink dis beter dat ons tydens die breektyd bietjie meer na julle verskille gaan kyk and see how we can resolve that as well." When trainees hold whispered private conversations, this one irritates me a lot, especially in the class. For alles ek klas geen ek besig om te praat en een of twee van julle begin gesels en lag en giggel, then I never know why you're laughing and what you're talking about. So in that instance, I would immediately ask, "Please share your joke with the class," or "Let's focus please," of "Kom ons doen 'n bietjie aktiwiteit dat almal kan saam deelneem." Once again, maintain the self-respect and the dignity of the participants. So moenie hulle verneder of afbreek nie, maar probeer hulle fokus weer terugkry tot by die res van die klas. And the last one, when a trainee has difficulty in expressing himself, veral wanneer jy met 'n skaam persoon te doen het, it's sometimes very hard for them to express what they're thinking and why they're thinking in that way. Die laaste gedeelte van hierdie hoofstuk is die belangrikheid daarvan om jou deelnemers betrokken te krijgen. We want to get them involved and they give you a few guidelines on page 100. Julle kan daardoor gaan, maar een van hulle is skep 'n klimaat van vertrouwen, vriendelijkheid en hulpvaardigheid. So you as a trainer have a role there to create that climate and maak seker dat allemaal dan weet hulle is waardeerd, hulle word raak gezien and that you do value their inputs as well. Also try to be open-minded. Not everyone thinks the way you do. Net omdat iemand van jou verskil, beteken nie, hulle is verkeerd of jy is reg of jy is verkeerd en hulle is reg nie. There are different opinions, different perceptions, so keep that in mind. Also make sure that you listen to your participants and not just by to what they're saying, but also look at their non-verbal communication. As hulle begin gaap of hulle begin belangstelling verloor, luister en sê hulle, alright, kom ons breek, kom ons vat gou 5 minute potty break, soos ek het altyd noem, en kom terug en dan doen ons weer 'n bietjie iets anders. So get them involved in that way as well. Die volgende een praat hulle weer eens van daardie non-verbal cues, kyk na hulle body language en wat hulle nie sê nie. Be careful not to criticize any effort, so when they ask a question or make a statement, moenie hulle kritiseer en afbreek nie. Vra baie vrae, begin met makkeliker vrae, dan bietjie moeiliker vrae. Don't answer the questions yourself. Kry jou deelnemers om die vrae ook te kan antwoord. En natuurlik, as hulle nie dadelik antwoord nie, gee kans. Stilte het nog niemand ooit doodgemaak nie. Partykeer het hulle nodig om te dink oor die vraag of oor die stelling voordat hulle antwoord. You can also ask them for their experiences, en ek doen dit nogal redelik gereeld in die klas, om te sê hoe jy werk by die plek, wat is jou ervaring, wat het jy geleer. So it's very important to get them to also share from their own experiences, en dan voel hulle ook trots dat hulle ook kan bydra tot die kursus. Always make eye contact, be enthusiastic, gebruik bietjie humor, laat hulle bietjie lag. I feel that sometimes using humor is the best way to get your participants involved. Hulle gee vir jou 'n klomp ander opdrag, gebruik verskillende metodes, use different media, that's what we've covered in the previous chapters as well. Gee bietjie omgewing wat hulle kan bietjie dink en bietjie kan gesels and just to converse with each other as well. And then of course planning for them to get to know each other through any activities or icebreakers that you can include. Okay, so daar is regtig baie wat 'n mens kan doen om jou werkers en jou leerders betrokke te kry. Try and apply these principles and you'll have a successful training session. Okay, in the next video we'll then start with module 7. So ons is nou klaar met hoofstuk 6. Ek hoop julle is allemaal nog met my. If there are any questions or any concerns, please feel free to ask them to me on the WhatsApp group and I'll try and respond appropriately when I have an opportunity. Maar tot dan, gesels ons weer. Bye!